Good morning to all. In our last class we were discussing about hybridization. So we are going to sum up that hybridization or VBT with our tabular column. So we shall write all the types of hybridization along with the coordination number. So coordination number, if coordination number is 2, if coordination number is 2, then hybridization will be sp. So which all orbitals involved also we'll see. So if it is sp, then it is 4s and 4px. So 1s, one orbital of s and one p orbital will be involved, and geometry is of linear. We have a linear geometry. Okay, so if coordination number is 3, then it is sp2. We have 4s, 4px and 4py. 4py we have, and we have trigonal planar. Trigonal planar geometry. So likewise, if coordination number is 4, then we'll come across with an hybridization as dsp2. So here we are going to involve 3d x square minus y square. It is 4s again, then 4px, 4py. So we have an geometry as a square planar geometry. Likewise, if it is 4 only, so we have with 4 different combinations. If it is 4, then it is sp3 hybridization also. So sp3 hybridization involves 4s, 4px, 4py and 4pz. We have tetrahedral geometry. Next, 4 again, it is sp2d. So s is 4s, p we have 4px, 4py, d we have, so here it is 4d x square minus y square. So these are the orbitals involved, and we have square planar geometry. Okay, so this is 4 if coordination number 4 is concerned. So 3 different hybridizations are possible, and 2 different geometries it is given. So likewise, we have if it is 5, the coordination number is 5. Next, so it might be dsp3. So d is 3d z square, 4s, 4px, 4py, and it is, so we have 3, so 4pz. So d, s and 3p orbitals are possible. It is trigonal bipyramidal. Likewise, so if it is 5, once again the possibility is sp3d. So if it is sp3d, orbitals almost same, but here it becomes 4d, that's it. 4d x square minus y square it is going to become. So we have an square pyramidal. Geometry changes, it will be square pyramidal. Next, sixth one, it is d2 sp3. D2, if it is there, then that if it starts with D, then it will be 3D itself. 3D x square minus y square, 3D z square, it is 4s, next it is 4px, 4py, 4pz. If it is 6, it is only one geometry it gives, that is octahedra. Okay. Likewise, if it is 6, one more possibility is sp3d2. So that is so it starts with 4s, 4px, 4py and 4pz. We have 4d x square minus y square, 4d z square. Okay, so it is octahedral again. Octahedral. Okay, so this is about the hybridization and the geometry with the coordination number. So if at all, if you check, let us discuss from the coordination number 4. So if at all, if you check this things, so if you include D in first, that is D in the beginning, that is 3D orbitals are there. Then these are called as inner orbital complexes. It is called inner orbital complex. Inner orbital complex, because 3D is involved, so that's why inner orbital complex it is. So when 3D will happen, when 3D involves in the hybridization, so when the ligand is a strong field ligand, if at all if it is inner orbital complex, so it is a strong field ligand it is going to form. So that is very very important. That means that the ligand will be an strong field ligand. Okay, so if at all if sp3 is concerned, we don't have d orbital over here, that means that so it is an outer orbital complex or d outer orbital, d is not involved, but still pairing doesn't take place, we can say that it is weak field ligand. Likewise, so if at all if it is sp2d is there, then also the same thing. So here also the same thing. So we have a weak field ligand itself. That means that no pairing is going to take place there also. So the 5. So we have two hybridizations. One is dsp3. Another one is sp3d. dsp3 is nothing but it is inner orbital complex. It is inner orbital complex. And this is outer orbital complex. So inner orbital complex where pairing takes place and D will be made free there. D will be made free. That means that it is a strong field ligand. And if at all, if it is outer orbital complex, then it is weak field ligand. So that is that is how by the hybridization or by the ligand, you can decide the hybridization. So if you know the ligand, then you can decide the hybridizations. So likewise, we have coordination number 6. So it is D2SP3. That is nothing but it is inner orbital complex. If it is inner orbital complex, then it is strong field ligand. So it is outer orbital complex. That means that here it is weak field ligand. So few exemptions are there. So that one in yesterday's video we have discussed. So a few exemptions are there. So apart from that, this is the general general thing we can sum up with VBT. We can sum up even our spectrochemical series also. It is a very large number of ligands we have. So to sum up that one, we can write. So first as halide donors. So after that we have oxygen donors. After that nitrogen donors. And next we have carbon donors. So the series It is like this. This end we have strong field ligands, and this end we have a weak field ligand. Okay. So we have many number of ligands present. So if at all, if it is sum up like this, it will be easier. So we have CN minus, we have carbonyl group. So likewise, so next comes is NH3 groups. After that, OH minus, O2 minus, we have. So after that, halogen atom. So in between that, we'll be getting ethylene, diamine. So all these things. So if at all, if it is remembered this order, then that is sufficient to identify whether it is a weak field ligand or strength of the ligand, you can easily identify. So next, we'll move on to CFT. Crystal field theory. So crystal field theory. It is octahedral complex. For octahedral complex, I have written here the diagram. Octahedral complex it is. Octahedral complex. So d orbitals are of 5 d orbitals. 5 different d orbitals we have. So those are dxy, dyz, dzx and dx square minus y square and dz square. So, these orbitals, these 5 orbitals, it has been present. So, when ligand approaches to them, in them also, dxy, dyz and dzx will be present in between the axis. And dzx square and dx square minus y square will be present along the axis. Now, in the octahedral complexes we are discussing. So, the metal with the d orbitals are present when ligand approaches to them. So, there will be the metal, in the metal also in d orbitals we have electrons and in ligands also rich in electrons. So, the ligand electrons and metal electrons will be having repulsion with one another. So, because of that repulsion, the energy is going to raise. The energy of the d orbital will be raised. So, when the ligand electrons, so it starts interacting with the metal d orbital, then those orbitals get split up into two sets. One is T2G set, another one is EG set. So, why this lower and higher? It is because, so when the ligand electrons approaches and interacts. So, here it is approaching. Here it is interacting. When it starts interacting, the splitting takes place. Why that differently it is going to interact is, so the ligand is going to, in octahedral complex, the ligand is going to interact or it will be along the axis. So that's why the orbitals which are along the axis will experience more repulsion. So more repulsion, the energy will be raised above. So less repulsion, so that's why it is below the average energy. So remember clearly, in octahedral complex, the ligands are approaching along the axis. So the orbitals along the axis will be raised up with the energy. So how much it is raised? It is raised. So this is what delta O it is. Delta O is nothing but a crystal field splitting energy. It indicates about the energy difference between the T2G set and the EG set. So now whatever the energy, the orbitals are there, so they are raised little higher than the normal. This is called barycenter, so which is the average energy of the orbitals. Average energy of the orbitals, it is raised by 3 by 5 delta O and it is decreased by 2 by 5 delta O. So, this is about the theoretical thing. So, if at all, if you have to check about the significance of crystal field stabilization, then we can say that, so significance of delta O, if at all, if it is delta O is less than P, P is nothing but pairing energy. So, we have orbitals over here, So, these orbitals, how the electrons will be filled. So if at all, if it is a weak field ligand, then delta O will be less. That means that, so the orbitals, whatever is there, it will be very closer to one another. Then, so let us think already, 3 electrons are already filled here. 3 electrons are already present. Three electrons are already present. Now the fourth electron has to be filled. So if at all, if it is an weak field ligand, if it is an weak field ligand, then the distance will be very less, because of which the fourth electron will move into the dx square minus y square orbital. I hope it is clear. So during the weak field ligand, so the distance between the these two orbitals will be very, very less, because of which the fourth electron will move into the above orbital. So we can say that the electronic configuration becomes, so here we have T2GZ. How many electrons are present? Three electrons are present, and in EG set one electron. That means that is the configuration. That is the configuration we have written. Three electrons here and one electron here. That is the configuration we have shown here. Suppose if at all, if it is, what is PP is pairing energy. Pairing energy is more, because of which pairing doesn't take place. Okay. So in the next case, we'll see that one also. If at all, if delta O is larger in case of crystal field, I mean strong field ligand. So that means that this distance, whatever is there, it is very larger. It is very larger. Then what happens? So the electrons, fourth electron doesn't move there. So the fourth electron will be present, because the distance is very large. Because of that reason, it cannot move to fourth. I mean, it cannot move to EG set. It will be getting paired up, because so distance is more and pairing energy is less, because of which the pairing takes place. So the above one we have written for weak field ligand, and this one for strong field ligand. You can observe now in the T2G set itself, for four electrons are present. In the EG set, we don't have any electrons at all. That means EG set is with zero electrons. So we can write the electronic configuration as T2G set. We have four electrons, and EG set with zero electrons. We'll take up a configuration with D5. And if at all, if it is weak field ligand, how the electrons will be filled, and if it is a strong field ligand, how the electrons will be filled, we shall see. So in a weak field ligand, we have two sets. So this is T2G set and this is the EG set. So since it is a weak field ligand, we know that delta O, the gap will be very less, because of which so five electrons we have to fill. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it is a 5. So you can observe. So what a pairing energy is very large. So that's why it doesn't get paired up. It will be filled in this manner. Likewise, we can also observe for strong field ligand, or else we'll complete with weak field ligand. So we need to calculate crystal field stabilization energy also. Crystal field stabilization energy. So how to calculate this one? So we have in T2G set, we have three electrons are present. So you can observe. So in T2G set, so what is the delta O here? Delta O is minus 0.4, and EG set we have 0.6. So we are going to club that one and we are going to calculate. So this is the delta O, or it is crystal field stabilization energy. So observe. So in T2G set, how many electrons are there? In T2G set, we have three electrons. So the down part is with 0.4, minus 0.4. How many electrons? We have three electrons plus. So in EG set, what is the difference again? What the difference was? Plus 0.6 there. Plus 0.6. How many electrons here? Two electrons. So it is minus 0.4 into 3. And plus 0.6 into 2. So the answer will be 0. So the crystal field stabilization energy is 0 there, or delta O is 0. Okay, next. So likewise, we have strong field ligand. So if at all, if it is strong field ligand, then how the distinguishing how the electronic filling will see. So here strong field ligand is there, means delta O will be very larger. They'll be far from one another. So orbitals are the electrons will get paired up here. Electrons will get paired up. So we can write it is Eg set and it is T2g set. Pairing energy is very less. So that's why it is getting paired up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So total 5 electrons in Eg set, no electrons at all. So we can write it. So we have how many unpaired electron here? 1 unpaired electron. In this, if you consider 5 unpaired electrons are present. So here crystal field stabilization energy we are calculating. It is minus 0.4 into how many electrons present? Total it is 5 electrons present. So we can write it is minus 2.0 it is minus. So crystal field stabilization energy is minus 2. So what magnetic properties also we can calculate, that is what mu value, spin only magnetic moment we can calculate, or magnetic moment in general, it is magnetic moment we can calculate. Mu is equals to square root of n plus 2, where n is 5. N is nothing but number of unpaired electrons. Unpaired electrons are 5. Here unpaired electron is 1. I hope it is clear. We have sum up that crystal field stabilization energy calculation. So that is for octahedral complex. It is minus 0.4 into number of electrons in T2G set and plus 0.6 into number of electrons in EG set. So we can also conclude that. So if at all, if you calculate for D0 and D10. So crystal field stabilization energy, crystal field stabilization energy is a zero for weak field as well as the strong field. So if at all, if D5 is concerned, for weak field we have zero and for strong field we have a value. So that means that, so D0, D10, crystal field stabilization in both the cases it is zero, and D5 for weak field it is a zero. So likewise we'll move on to tetrahedral complex. So in case of a tetrahedral complex, so it is for tetrahedral. So crystal field for tetrahedral complex. The same way splitting takes place, but here in tetrahedral complex, so the ligands will be approaching. The ligands will be approaching in between the axes. So the orbitals with in between the axes will be experience more repulsion. So they are raised with the energy. Likewise, so the orbitals with along the axis will be experiencing less repulsion. So decreased with the energy. It is minus 0.6 because it is decreased very less. So that's why it is minus 0.6 delta T. So delta T is nothing but crystal field stabilization energy in tetrahedral field. So we can sum up that crystal field stabilization energy also. So crystal field stabilization energy for tetrahedral it is. For tetrahedral we can write it just like our other octahedral, how we have written it is minus 0.6 into number of electrons in EG set plus it is 0.4 into number of electrons in T2G set. It is not paired or unpaired, it is total number of electrons present. So here we can conclude that, so whether it is D0, D5 or it is D10, so crystal field stabilization energy will be, crystal field stabilization energy is zero, whether it is strong field, weak field, whatever may be the case, but it will remain zero. So this is what our conclusion. So in comparison with tetrahedral and octahedral complexes, so if at all, if it is being checked, so what a delta T is always very much smaller. We are comparing now crystal field stabilization in tetrahedral complex with crystal field stabilization in octahedral complex. So it is a very, very smaller tetrahedral complex. The crystal field stabilization is very much smaller. than the octahedral complex. So the relation between them is delta T is equals to 4 by 9 into delta O.